to stay vital in every aspect of our lives, and that's, I understand that's a pretty broad question, but you're a very, very brilliant doctor, so you can tell us the short version of how to stay vital.
You know, it's very simple. It's just what Grandma told us. To stay vital, we have got to have work on three different areas. We have to have good food, and good food means sitting down at a table and having diverse foods. Look for a lot of colors on the plate, fresh fruits, vegetables, good source of protein, number one. Number two, I believe, if you can, take nutritional supplements that will give you additional benefits. Number three, exercise moderately. Everything has to be in moderation. And then the fourth area is really lifestyle. You've got to have the right attitude. And so we can create this within ourselves, positive approach to life. And those are the magic. We stay vital and young into our 90s.
Wow. You know, I got a, by the way, I just want to say this. I got an email on my Facebook today. There was a picture of you and me together, and somebody commented that they thought we both were aging well. Well, I wanted to pass it along to you. I think that's
The question is, do they think we're 90?
I replied, not bad for a guy who's 100, and I was referring to myself. right in the middle of our conversation, I want you to tell everybody what your website is, because they can go to your website and or get the book for more details, but I want them to know what the website is.
The website, just go to drperricone.com, and there's other variations, but Perricone or Dr. Perricone MD, whatever you'd like to choose, you'll get there. And interesting, because we have a lot of information on the website. We have the three-day diet, which is the one you take 3 days before any special event that really makes you look 10 years younger in 3 days.
Wow.
A lot of information about the various topical products, the anti-inflammatories that will help maintain that youthful appearance. And then a lot of resources, too, in terms of history of the work we've done.
Wow. I hadn't had a chance to check that out, so I didn't know about that three-day diet. That sounds like a big winner to me. Now, your diet is for all ages, and it's probably a good idea for younger people to start on that just as soon as they possibly can, so they can blaze a nice, healthy trail for their future.
What I always say to parents is you have a tremendous ability to influence your children's lives by just introducing them to the right way to eat. It's going to improve their cognitive function. They're going to do better in school. They're going to grow healthier and better immune system. And so we have that power. And so if you give that to the children, then they can then pass it on to their children as well.
You know, and a good influence from your mom and dad is a good thing. One of the things in talking to people, I hear women complaining about all the time, Dr. Perricone, is hot flashes. Is there something that somebody can take charge with their diet and try and at least lessen the severity of those?
Yeah, there's actually very strong proof of that. If we get away from Western society like we see here in the United States or Europe, and we look at some of the cultures that actually do have good diets and they moderate exercise, they don't go through those symptoms of menopause. They don't have the hot flashes, they don't have the depression. So we know that looking at those societies, we can reproduce the same here. Following the anti-inflammatory diet, moderate exercise wants a good positive approach.
And of course, you do have a line of products that will assist people with all of these things as well.
Yes, we have a number of products that will assist them. And of course, nutritional supplements are very important. But once again, following that anti-inflammatory diet, which is what Grandma told us to do, fresh fruits, vegetables, moderate amounts of food, stay away from the starches and sugars.